CodeLens is a developer heads-up display that provides key contextual information about code inline in the editor. It allows you to keep your focus in the editor and reduce costly context switching. Let's see CodeLens in action. We'll start by looking at a method that you're probably not familiar with and find out what we can learn about it using CodeLens indicators. Above each method is a line of contextual data which includes the CodeLens indicators. While we will use the mouse for convenience during this video, you can easily access the CodeLens indicators by holding down the Alt key. A fixed number is assigned to each indicator to provide easy access. The first indicator shows four references in our example. If I click here, you can see what other code accesses this method. I can hover over each of these to see a preview of the surrounding code where the call is made, and I can double-click to navigate to that code. Clicking back will return me to the method we're examining. The second indicator shows the status of unit tests that cover this method. You can see here that only two out of the three tests are passing for the index method. Normally, CodeLens is designed to minimally impact the code in the editor. But in this case, because a failing unit test is sufficiently urgent, a red error icon is shown to draw attention to the error. When all of the unit tests are passing, no icon is shown as there is no need to draw attention in that case. Clicking off the pop-up or pressing Escape closes the window. Have you ever wanted to know who's been working on a particular piece of code? The authors indicator shows that Shane Hughes-Borton plus two others have checked code in that has modified this method. This time I'm going to hold down the Alt key and press the right arrow to take me to the next indicator. This indicator is the changes indicator, and it shows 5 plus 1, which means that there have been 5 change sets checked in for this method, and there has been 1 check-in since the last time I did a get latest. Hovering over the indicator shows me who has checked in, and I can easily access the diff to see exactly what's changed. The remaining three CodeLens indicators show us that there have been 2 bugs resolved against this code, 1 work item linked to the code, and a single code review. It is often helpful to know if code has been reviewed, including who has reviewed it and what the results were. This is yet another question answered by CodeLens. CodeLens also helps us keep our code in shape. You'll remember that we have a unit test failing, and someone has checked code in since our last get latest. Let's get latest now, rebuild our solution, and then run all unit tests that cover this particular code. That's much better. We can also manually choose to refresh our CodeLens indicators. The final thing we'll look at is CodeLens integration. Reaching out to other developers is a common requirement. We can easily communicate via link to ask a colleague a question, or perhaps you prefer email. In this video, we've seen how CodeLens can help you learn about a method, property, or class, including its references, its tests and their status, its history including who changed it, how it was changed and why it was changed, and easily explore this information further, or get in touch with the right people directly, all without leaving the editor.